Hello everyone, welcome to this session. In this session, we will learn about the plotting the graph of the learning curve. As in the previous session, we have discussed about the what is a learning curve. Okay, here we will discuss about plotting the graph in the Jupyter notebook. For that, I've opened the Jupyter notebook. And what is learning curve? First of all, it shows the validation. Okay, it shows the validation and the training score of the estimator. Estimator means classifier. Okay, for the varying number of the training sample, it is a tool to find out how much we benefit from adding more training data and whether the estimator suffer from the variance error or the bias error. This definition you will get in the previous session video. Okay, so first of all, what I am doing here, I am loading the CSV file which contains the coordinate of the point and its state. Okay, whether it's positive or negative. Okay, and then I'm converting into the numpty array x and y. Okay, taking the column x1 and x2 and making an array of that. Same way for the column y also. Okay, now coming down here, so I'm defining one function here where I'm taking the parameter as the numpty array x, y, estimator is the classifier as told before, and num training that you will come to know in later in this function. Okay, so now what I am doing here, I am calling the function learning curve. So this is a predefined function, okay, in the sklearn module. So what I am taking here, again here I am taking the giving the passing the argument as the estimator x, y, and c. What is c? This is the k-fold cross validation. So in case of k-fold cross validation, we break our data into k buckets. Like in this case, we have k5. So we will train our model 5 times. Each time using the different bucket as our testing set and a training set. Okay. This whole thing I've already discussed in the previous videos. You can refer to that. Okay. Now n job equal to 1. So this means that how many job you will run in a parallel. So here number of job that will run in parallel is 1 only. And same way, if it is minus 1, that means that all the processors will be used here. Okay. Now coming here, this is train size equal to np numpy dot lean space. So lean space also I have already discussed. So this is the starting point and this is the ending point. And how many division you want to break this number in between this interval, how many interval you will create. I mean, different sizes of the training set you will create. Okay, so first of all, what I will do, I will print this. In order to understand more, I will print this one, np.linspace 0.121 and num training. Okay, so let's see. So as I have given here this parameter as num training, so when I call the function, I have given the 5 here. So that means num training value is 5. Okay, so when I'm printing this np.linspace 0.1 to 1.0 and this num training is 5, so that means from 0.1 to 1, 5 equal parts will be divided here. Okay, so 0.1, 0.325 and this way, all this. So what do you mean by this? So this means it gives a fraction of the maximum size of the training set. Okay, so this is the fraction of the maximum size of the training set. Okay, so when this function is called and what it returns. It will return the train size, train score and test score. Let's see what it contains in the train size. So when we print this train size, so you can see here that train size is this. That means the fraction which we have calculated in the np.lin space, that is a fraction of the maximum size of the training set. That will be multiplied with the maximum size of the training set. That means you will get the value here. The same way, all this here. So that means 80 points is being used for the training set. So that means if you multiply with 8, it will be 8. Same way, all this. So you have understood about the train size. Okay. Now, what it contains in the train score. Okay. So in the previous lesson, you will come to know about how to find out the error, training error, and all. Okay. So this function also returns the train score also. So train score is calculated by counting the number of correctly classified point in the model. And then it will divide with the total number of the training set. used to train the model. Okay, so first of all, let's see here. So here what I am doing, first the training set. So first we will increase the size of the training set. First we are taking the small size, that is 8 points is being used to train the model. Okay, then here you will come, here you can see in while we will train the model with that 8 training set, then 7 of them are correctly classified and 1 is incorrect classified. So that means 7 by 8, that will result into 0.875. Okay. So now as we have taken this CV equal to 5, that means we will take the 8 training set only, but we will take a different training set bucket, 5 different set of buckets here. So 5, we'll take again another 8 training set. And we will again train the model and we will calculate the training score, how much it is correctly classified. So you will get this, like if it is, I think it will be 5 by 8. Okay, 5 is correctly classified. Okay, and 3 is not correctly classified. So 5 by 8 here. Okay, same way all the 8 training set, it will calculate here. Okay, now again we will increase the size of the training set, 26. Now 26 training set will be used to train the model and we will calculate the training score here. Okay, so this is the result here. Okay, so now again we have trained the model with the 26 set of training data. Again we will take the 44 training set and we will calculate the training score. Okay, so now this training score you have calculated. Now we will see what is test score. So as we have taken training set as 8, 26, 44, the same way testing set will be there. So for testing set also, we will find the scores also. So when we print this, you will get this value. Okay. Now let's see what happens here. So we will take again the score mean. So we find out the mean of the, we find out the CV equal to 5, as we already told before, like cross validation, we will find a 5 different set, 5 different times we will find out the score. So we will take the average of all this 5. Okay. So when we take the average, we get this result. Same way for the 26 set of data, we will take the average and we get this result. Okay. So this is the mean for the train score. Same way for the test score also, we will take the mean. And standard deviation I have taken here, but it's not important here to take the standard deviation here. Okay, so again, now you will plot the graph here. So for that, I have given the title, X label and Y label. And then we will plot the graph where I am giving the parenthesis argument as train size. That means this is the X axis and this is the train score mean. That will be Y axis. Okay, and I am giving that colored as a green. And label as a training score. So for training score, the graph will be plotted here. You can see here, the green graph is for the training learning curve, training learning curve. Okay. So where you can see that this is the training size. Okay. And this is the train score mean, which we have calculated before. So for 8 number of the training set, you got the average of 0.675. That is, you can see here. Same way for 26. Set of training data, you have got this result. So we have plotted the graph for the training score. Okay, now let's see for the test score also. Okay, so for test score mean also, we have find out we have drawn the graph and given the color as yellow. So this is the cross validation score here. So this is the learning curve of the cross validation score. Okay, so now let's see what happened again. So okay, this plotted the graph and now we need to call this function. Okay, so first of all I have defined the classified as a logistic regression. I am drawing the graph for the logistic regression and then I am calling this function, giving the estimator x, y and num training 5. Okay, so graph is plotted for the logistic regression here. So by looking at the learning curve, you can guess like it is not a good graph. As when you see this, two graph is will not converge at a particular point. Okay, so that means this is not a good graph. okay, and now we'll check the another model. So another model will be decision tree classifier. We will define this and then we will call this function. So let's see the graph for this. So learning curve for the training set of training set, it is one here. This is the graph, and for cross validation score is learning curve is this. So that means you can see here this two graph is will converge at a particular point. So that means the error is being reduced at some particular point. So that means this graph is better from another logistic regression. So for this set of data, we guess like the decision tree classifier is the model is good. So by looking at learning curve of a different classifier, you can identify which model is good for the particular set of data. So in this lesson, you have learned about the learning curve. I will see you in the next class. Thanks for watching this video.